In America, the white middle class is packing up and driving away. They're fleeing the gated communities far from the cities. Here in California, more than 40% of new homes are built behind a wall.
One out of every two new houses built in this state is behind the gate. It's getting so gated and divided that people's toilets have their own zip code.
The Golden State is becoming the land of haves and have-nots. Those inside the gates versus those outside. But what are these people running from? And what are they looking for? I'm going way out into the Mojave Desert, 80 miles east of Los Angeles, to live in one of California's oldest and biggest gated communities. It prides itself on being one of the safest places in the country. In fact, the residents like it so much, it's even got its own slogan, a bit of paradise.
Charlie, look up.
First thing I learned, security here is tight. Private guards 24/7. No invitation, no identification, forget about it. You're not getting in.
Okay, Charlie?
Yes, sir.
Okay, bud. Got it right here. There you go, bud.
Okay.
You have a nice day, huh?
World peace paradise.
World peace paradise, bud.
Inside the gates, it's all private land. Residents pay $1,500 a year in service fees for the clean, secluded life. I've been a reporter for the New York Times for the last 10 years, and I've been a lot of places, but I've never been inside a gated community before. This one's even got its own newspaper.
Property Owners Association notes. House for sale, house for sale, house for sale. New listing, beautiful home. Seller will entertain all offers. Sale pending. Wow, listed and sold, 1.8 million. Another house for sale? It's a lot of houses for sale.
I'm 40, married, and got a baby on the way. I'm wondering if this could be a good place to raise the kid. So I've moved in for a month, thought I'd try and get to know the neighbors, see what the suite life's all about. This is Randy Roberts. He lives and sells the Canyon Lake Dream. He moved his family here a few years ago and willed himself into a prime house smack dab center on the lake.
We do have a Hollywood celebrity that does have a lake house out here.
Who's that?
Is it okay if I mention his name?
I don't know.
I'll say it anyway. Kiefer Sutherland actually bought a house out here about a year and a half ago.
These days, Randy's a long way from the shot and beer joint he used to run. He owes it all, he tells me, to motivational tapes and the power of positive thinking.
Okay, so what's the things that you heard in those tapes and those seminars that lit the light bulb?
To reach the top, to soar like an eagle, you have to eliminate yourself from surrounded by turkeys. In other words, to soar like an eagle, get away from the turkeys. Not going into a long-winded story, when I realized that back in 1995, that truly impacted our life tremendously, because, you know, most of my friends and associates were turkeys. And when I branched off and got eagle wings and flew away, our life changed remarkably.
Let me ask you, lady, what's out there?
Well, it's a very fast-paced living style, for sure. I mean, we're relaxing right here. What are they doing? Honking their horns, swearing under their breath, get out of my way. A lot of stress. Cost of, you know, homes there. Still.
Well, we'll watch the news tonight, and there'll be somebody that's in some kind of shooting. There'll be some kind of gangbang or gang activity out there. The benefit for us is they're not inside. They're outside looking in. That's why we live here in Canyon Lake. In a private gated community where there are rules and regulations that prevent that from happening outside of the gates, no control. Do we feel for some of the people that are experiencing that? Yeah, because we have family members that are in that situation right now. And because of that, we may get another for sale sign in a different city, because they're moving. They're coming here to Canyon Lake.
Splish, splash, I was taking a bath. Long about a Saturday night.
If I'm going to immerse myself in the Canyon Lake scene, then I figure I'll have to dive right in.
High five, girl.
Canyon Lake was a pensioner's paradise, a Viagra Valhalla. It all used to look like this, I'm told, until young families fleeing Los Angeles began to pour in. The community's changing, but the new people are finding there's a price to paradise. Rules. Tons of them. No barking dogs, no speeding, no loud colors on your house, no motorcycles, no reckless golf cart driving, no, no, no. If you get upset with the rent-a-cops who enforce these rules, bite your tongue. Rude language is a $50 fine.
No sidewalks, nobody walking around. Community kind of implies you hang around. Yeah, there's a Mexican guy working. So far, about the only people I've seen are the Mexicans raking the lawns. And look, they got a bar.
It turns out, gates aren't just for the rich people. Look, regular working class guys drinking in the garage. Not everyone's got the money to live on the lake.
I work from 6 in the morning till 3:30 in the afternoon, so I get home and sit down at the water and enjoy a beer with my friends. That's life. When I travel, like I just got home Saturday, I know that my family's safe. It's not like when I was young, when I lived in Venice Beach and it was all fun and games. Now you go down there and get shot at night.
It's got to this point in the country where you gotta pay to have some order.
We live in the same state, but we gotta pay for our privacy. We gotta pay for our humanity. We gotta pay for our happiness. But if that's what you gotta do, man, you know, I'll pay for it.
Well, what happens to the outside?
Fuck the outside. That's what matters is in here.
People routinely tell me they left the cities for Canyon Lake because of their children. But for a kid without a car, the place can be isolating. I meet this teenager in the park. His name is Remington.
How old are you?
17.
They didn't really build this with you in mind, did they?
Nah. They built it for little kids and old people. And all the people that want to have the big boat and the big car and all that crap.
What were you into?
I don't know. Pretty much there with God, but still playing with the devil.
Remy tells me he's had a rough time. Divorced mom, drug problems, kicked out of the house. He's moved just up the cul-de-sac to his aunt's house. He dreams of the outside world.
Much to do here?
Around here, there ain't shit to do except get drunk or go smoke weed.
City's got rules, doesn't it?
Rules of its own. They don't like me. I'm a poor kid.
You're not supposed to be in here, man. You're bringing down property values or something like that.
The gates are just to raise the old people's self-confidence, I think. It's the whole theory behind living in a gated community. You're safer. It's just theory. It's not like there isn't tweakers and druggies that don't live in here, you know? Hell, I've been ripped off by them.
Do you know what's going on outside these gates?
A lot of drugs, that's all I know.
That's true. But what are you gonna do, man? Can't stay here forever. You can't afford it.
Mm-mm. I don't wanna stay here forever. As soon as I turn 18, I'm going to the military if they accept me.
But Canyon Lake isn't just a gated community. It's a gated city, no less. One of five in California. Outside the gates, It's a strip mall of shops, cops, and nail salons. Even the popular night spot is owned by Marty the Mayor. It's a friendly place. And to keep it friendly, new blood is elected to the association board every 2 years. These are the people who make sure the rules are followed and the roads get swept. And just as I move in, it's election time again. I show up to a party of movers and shakers and meet one of the candidates, Denise Jordan, who is married to Monty Jordan, a former Hollywood stuntman.
And kind of like how our lake appears to be, you know, so beautiful. I would love for it to, like when people drive by, I would love for them to go, oh my gosh, what is that, you know?
My sister lives in LA, and every time she comes here, you know, she's like, this is the best place to live. It's the best family place. It's the best,
Gladtown.
She calls it Gladtown because we're all, you know, connected.
If someone is in this community and not getting along, just the social pressure from the neighbors is going to be enough to have them move. I mean, I've seen that in 12 years so many times.
Tell me if this sounds good, sweetheart. Good evening, everyone. My name is Denise Jordan. This will be my first board position, but
Denise must give a speech to the town in 2 weeks. She says she wants to pretty up the place and create something for the kids to do.
Our lake situation, of course, I consider one of our most important assets.
Our goal would be to get on that lake, wouldn't it be, honey? Are we trying to get on that lake?
I'm happy with the golf course.
You're happy with the golf course?
Yeah, I'll drive the 500 yards to the lake to take the boat, thank you.
When you build a city in the middle of a desert, a lake is the crowning jewel, the place to be, even if it is man-made and green.
The kind of skiing I did growing up was sliding down the stairs in a pillowcase.
Randy and his friends take me out for a taste of the good life.
Are you ready?
Yeah. Would you ask me if I ever done this before? No. Not everybody gets to grow up on the lake.
Yeah. Yeah, but sometimes everybody gets an opportunity, and now you're taking advantage of that.
Yeah. You're never gonna do it.
La Viva Loca! Come on, this is it, Charlie! Wait, are you done?
Yeah, I'm done.
Oh, you sure?
Oh, spell no, and you are not it this time around.
I'd seen what the boys get up to, and now I spend some quality time with the girls.
Show us some of the pretty, pretty bras. Rhinestones, I love
Randy's
rhinestones.
Wife, Denise, takes me to a private party at a house just up the road.
At the bottom.
Every woman here has nice jewelry and even nicer breasts.
Really fun. Isn't that cute?
Denise and Randy come from a humbler place. And I wonder if living in a closed society has pressured them into staring at their navels, dressing the part, keeping up with the Joneses.
Did the Joneses, that whole thing start to seep into you?
Well, I have to admit that I wasn't really into jewelry. Where out here, once I moved, you notice all the women always have all these diamonds on. I can go out in the East Bay, say we're out on our boat in our bikinis getting a suntan. And these girls have their diamond earrings, diamond necklaces. It's like, you know, it's time to show off every time you go out in public. And all of a sudden you start picking up on that and going, oh, look, she's got diamonds on her fingers, she's got diamonds on her ears, and you start thinking, wow, I only have, you know, my wedding ring, my diamond, maybe I need to start getting some diamonds. It just does have a, you know, it triggers something that you kind of think, oh, okay, so that's kind of the thing to do.
Are those real diamonds?
Oh, no, these aren't real.
Don't worry about it. You look good, girl. Don't worry about that.
But see, I went and I had to get one of these.
You ever had surgery?
Oh, I've had surgery.
Some plastic surgery.
Oh, yeah.
What did you get?
Yeah, well, see, for my birthday this year, I got boobs. Hello.
The mission is to get the name out so people know who I am, the people who are supporting me, and so when people drive by and they say, oh, everybody's voting for Denise, let's vote for her. Right. I think our first location should be over in the town center.
Out there?
Mm-hmm.
We're going out there?
We're going out there.
Is that okay?
On a busy road with us?
Yeah, you're safe.
Okay.
Ready?
Trust you.
All right, darling, here we go. Need anything before we go?
No.
Water? Juice.
I need a Thompson.
Okay, babe. It's very funny.
I put this in my book, didn't I?
Okay. Oh! I thought that was Terry. Hello!
Hi. This is Town Center?
This is where all the Canyon Lake people do business because we have our own restaurants, our own sports bar. Right over there, around the other side, is where I get my nails done. We have a doctor, we have a bank. It's just our own little town center.
So this is where you go when you go out, usually?
Well, this is where we go...
When you need to go out.
When we need to go out. Next destination.
We want.
You want what?
That's the whole question about American life. What is it you want?
You know, I think when you're younger, you want stuff. But I think when you're older, I think you want peace.
Then you start getting stuff, and then you start wanting what your neighbors got.
I know, but how much stuff do you need? I have so much stuff, I don't even know where it is. We don't need any more stuff. Come on. I think it's time to start giving back.
Even when you realize that you've got enough stuff, that's not enough. You begin to crave prestige, standing in the community, some kind of meaning. Okay, and a house on the lake. Someone told me when I moved in that when you come through the gate, you have a deep sense of relief. The outside world has been locked out. But when you lock out the outside world, do you lock yourself in? Remy wants to show me a hole in the fence where the outside kids sneak in.
Are you allowed to be here?
Yeah.
So this is like the hood.
There ain't no ghetto part. This is just closest to the ghetto.
So this is the Canyon Lake fence?
Yep. This blocks out everything that's outside of Canyon Lake. Supposedly. This is where the hole was. I guess they patched it up.
Oh, they patched up the hole?
Yeah. Pretty soon there's gonna be another one, though.
Who lives over there?
The Latino Americans and more Latino Americans and some white people and some black people, and I guess you could say a lot of them are drug dealers or gangsters. I don't know.
That's the hood?
Yeah. That's the hood of this area.
That's like Mexico of this area.
Yeah.
And this fence is to keep them out.
Yeah. Out there, there's no rules.
Out there, you'd be free and work it out.
Yeah.
Dude, if I help you, is that a felony?
Okay.
Be free, young man. Hey, listen, be careful out there. Seriously, once you go, I can't.
My shirt got cut.
Whoa, dude, get word to him out there, man. I'm trapped. get some help, get me out of here. How are you, brother?
Feel safe?
No, I feel lonely.
Why? Because everything outside this gate's free and you kind of don't got much to do inside?
No, man. I see a fellow human being over there. Got a good shine to his eyes. I'd probably like to get to know him. But this prevents it. I couldn't even shake your hand. Come on back into the womb, man. Crawl back into the warm environs. Come on back in where you belong.
Should I just hop the fence?
Yeah, sure. Well, Welcome home.
The gates are supposed to keep the outside world out and keep Canyon Lake a safe, clean place. But I'm starting to realize that out there has trickled in here anyway. I drive down to the community center, the lodge, but when I get there, it's empty as usual. What I see are tattooed kids drinking outdoors and smoking weed, both illegal in the outside world, but apparently not in here. Fence or no fence, rules or no rules, people do what they want. I'm too old for this scene, so I go to town for a coffee.
Dude, I love this place a whole lot, bro. That right there on top of that Inland Empire is the symbol for Canyon Lake you'll find on the big wall.
This is where I'm from. I love it. It's awesome. It's very unique. You won't find another place like this. You may find places now that are putting gates in front of their stuff, but we have our own security here that writes you a ticket. We have, I mean, this is the only city. What's great about it is you're not getting harassed by a police officer. You're just getting the ticket. And I'm happier to get ticketed by him than a guy that could take me to jail and search my car and find my weed.
Justin tells me he works in porno films. Yep, they got that in here too.
I never watched porn a day in my life till I found out I was gonna direct one. And that's when I watched my first damn porn. I didn't have to, I grew up here with all these sex addicts, a place that has a little community and four bars in the shopping center across the street, a place that allows open beverages in public. Go ahead, get in your golf cart and drive around with a beer, and then tie off your boats like the damn river and show your wife's tits to every 15-year-old in town. Do this, but you know what? That guy over there, he's bad, works in porn. It's a joke, dude. These people are so hypocritical here, it's great, but that's the American way, dude. Be bad and look good.
Inside those. What more could a man want than an exotic porn life? Perhaps an exotic pet?
I had all these animals, I had a whole living room full of terrariums, and finally the pet I always wanted was an alligator. In my newest house, I built a whole pond in the back, man. A gigantic pond, and with a wall around it and everything for this alligator, and he got an infection in a tooth, and he wound up dying, so in honor of Lynyrd Skynyrd, which was his name, we decided to take, and he's in my freezer right now waiting until we find somebody that can stuff him.
Let me see Lynyrd. Hey, what are you doing in there?
Where the fuck's my alligator?
How's it feel, man? Feel caged?
Can't have him out for a long time. Might start to thaw.
Hey, pull him out, put him on the counter.
Yeah,
just do it real quick. He's got a good thing on him. Come on, Lynyrd.
He's Lynyrd Skynyrd, dude.
Now, here. Okay, here.
You might want to move the baby stuff before you...
Oh, yeah. I'm going to clean all that.
Okay.
That's my alligator.
I want you to interview Lynyrd about living in Canyon Lake.
How did he like it?
Yeah, ask him.
How did you like living in Canyon Lake, Lynyrd?
It's all right.
What?
It's all right.
It's all right? Well, considering it's a desert in Southern California, it seems like you'd be stoked that you got a lake community.
I'm a little bit cold.
Well, you're dead.
You've got me living in the cage.
I built you a wonderful home, but you can't use it because you might start to deteriorate.
There's too many rules. You'll never come to visit me anymore.
What do you mean? We're visiting right now, dude. I'm not talking this out.
I can hardly breathe. Set me free. Let us move back to LA, okay? Come on, Sarai.
Look, we gotta put him up, dude. He's gonna start to thaw and I won't be able to find a person for him.
But I like it. But that again. It's cold in there, I can't move. I feel so rigid, the traps in here.
Help me put away my alligator, man.
Okay. That is the trippiest thing I've seen. Hey, do me a favor, here you go.
No,
do one thing.
No,
give me a commercial. Give me a 1 minute commercial, Canyon Lake.
No.
Come on, and action.
No, I'm not doing it, man. I'm not pitching that commercial. Move to Canyon Lake? I don't know. I ain't got it.
Justin pitches Canyon Lake, take 3.
Come to Canyon Lake where you can modify everything. You can even put your house on shocks. Come on over. We got 4 bars just outside the community, and you can have an open beverage anywhere you like. Feel free to drive your golf cart drunk and anywhere you want to go, and hit on everyone else's wife. Why not? She'll be showing her tits down at the main lake later. See you at the lodge. Oh, no, I won't. No one goes there. Stole that from him. Canyon Lake. See you there.
Canyon Lake is bush country, white, Christian, and middle class. People here pine for the good old days of mowed lawns and smiling neighbors. Tonight, 5 candidates pitch their visions for the city's 13,000 citizens.
But also, it will
preserve and increase our property values.
The older crowd talks prices and fees. For Denise, it's status. She wants to give the people her heart and help the kids.
And our young people, what are we going to do to help them as we grow?
The city, it's obvious, is changing. It turns out Canyon Lake is more than a city. It's a kind of real-life Stepford Wives, where the men run things and the women make cupcakes.
Whoever owns a home here can vote, meaning, let's say the husband is the prime, and he's the person on the loan and owns has his name on the title. How come the wife doesn't get to vote? If he dies, the wife still can't vote?
Oh, no, if he dies,
I can vote then? Oh, good.
Per property, there's only one vote.
See, that doesn't make sense to me.
And it's for the male?
The male is the prime member.
Randy, one of the newer residents, doesn't seem to have gotten the recipe. Listen to her argue with the vice president of the board.
And I can vote for the president of the United States, but I can't vote for the president of here.
I have 9 pieces of property here, so I've got 9 votes.
That's not fair. Okay, oh.
Oh, you're the man.
Okay.
I live in one house and rent out 7 or 8 others.
And you vote for all those.
But I vote for each one of those others.
So isn't that like kind of democracy? I mean, is that wrong?
No,
is that wrong
called,
that I think?
It's called dictatorship. Uh-huh.
Randy invites me over to her house for a party. This is by far the most diverse crowd I've seen here.
Don't make me pull out the best shot.
And everyone wants to be like Baywatch. Everybody's got the Baywatch. I see it right there, and maybe, yeah, my own wife.
That's the best
my
we got to offer, though.
My own wife. Yeah. Baywatch.
Back in the day, Canyon Lake had a reputation as a white racist community. Today, money talks and anyone can buy their way in. Even so, it's still 94% white. And as usual, when you mix drink with mixed company, the conversation gets hot.
Why are you saying
you're like one of 3 black people in this lake?
I know exactly how many there are here. And there is more than 3.
I'm telling you.
You counted.
We've got 5 Asian people.
Honey, I lived here for almost 5 years. I've counted them, trust me. I know more about how many there are than you do. I've got stats and stuff, and I'll tell you why. It's because I grew up in a very small Canyon Lake type community.
White.
Where I was the only one except for my brother. And my brother was like, later, dude, I'm out of here. You know, I was the only one, and I always said that I would never do that. Then I move out here to Canyon Lake.
Mom,
I went to the one when they had it.
In America, we still haven't solved the black and white thing.
Hey, what up, Paulie?
The next day, I catch up with Paul.
In every city and every state across America, you've got different congregations of people that group together. You have Italians, Jewish people, black people, Mexicans that all group together. So we're a bunch of white people that just group together behind some gates. I don't see it any different. I don't think that, you know, a white man has those privileges, you know, because then it's looked upon as being racist.
There's no question California's changing. In the last 50 years, the population has nearly tripled. Much of that growth is Mexican and Central American. This is Lake Elsinore, just down the road from Canyon Lake. Here, they're mostly poor and unskilled. As the wealthier and predominantly white residents retreat to their walled compounds with their money, the dark-skinned arrivals are allowed in once a week to wash their floors and mow the lawns. Every day you can find Latinos standing right outside the gates of Canyon Lake, hoping for a day's work inside.
Trabajaron en el pasado en Canyon Lake?
Sí, they have their own security there inside the border.
Otro border?
Yeah. You gotta have a pass to get in there. Yeah.
How much do you get paid an hour?
Sometimes from $8 to $10.
$8 to $10?
Yeah.
Each morning the scene's the same. Maids, gardeners, construction workers come to work. They're brown, the bosses are white, and nobody's getting in without a pass. This could be anywhere in America, except for the gate.
I'd be working here. You know, and people going by, hey, you dirty Mexican wetback, go home. But they don't know me. They don't know my history.
Richard is a fourth-generation American. He grew up in Lake Elsinore and married a white woman from Canyon Lake. They used to live in her mother's house until Richard couldn't take it anymore.
A lot of the neighbors used to come out and looking out their windows, at the blinds. Every time I come out, they were always looking, watching me. And, you know, that kind of made me feel real funny because every time I came out, they were outside to see what I was going to do or what I was, you know. I don't know what was their problem. I guess they thought I was going to steal something or something. But, you know, so it just made me feel funny. So I got out of Canyon Lake and moved out, you know. Because, you know, I used to come fishing over here, and people used to look at me when I used to fish right here. But then they used to come up to me, hey, what are you doing here? You ain't supposed to be here. But, you know, I had every right to be here. My mother-in-law lived here. You know, she invited me in here. But there's other people that say, hey, you don't belong in here. You know, I'm over there fishing, having a good old time with my kids and stuff. And that kind of, you know, bums me out, man. Because, you know, if I had a lawnmower or a blower or a rake in my hand, it's okay for me to be in here, you know? So.
Let's get out by sunset.
Yes.
Are gated cities the latest form of American segregation? Are walled cities our future or the death of our great experiment? If brown people find it hard being inside the gates, I wonder how young white people see life on the outside. There's a group of them hanging out at the beach. I stopped to ask.
But a hoe needs more than the average man. She wants a motherfucker with a retirement plan. So, baby, don't cry the blues, cause I know a gang of hoes in your shoes when I'm on speed.
What do you think's outside here for you?
What's left for middle-class white kids?
Yeah.
It's going downhill.
Well, obviously. Nobody cares about an education anymore.
Come in and then we'll do the same jobs we'll do, but they'll do them for below minimum wage and for fucking slim pickings. It's like for the same fact, like, I'm a racist person, but I would rather see a fucking black guy get a job that's legally an American than some illegal Mexican that fucking hops the border to come over here, you know?
Why are white people 3/4 of the population of the United States and they feel like a minority?
Because we have immigration. There's at least 1 million Mexicans that fucking hop the border.
That's exactly right. We're the minority in Elsinore. I'll tell you that right now. We're white people, and if we go in Elsinore and I got a shaved head and I got my bandana on my head, who do you think's gonna get shot? Me or the Mexican? Me.
You're so pissed off about your rights, but you're not doing anything about it. He's never getting drunk on a beach.
America wasn't founded on nigger love and everything. It was founded on niggers being niggers. Fuck the four fathers were made on white people for a white survival.
Are you a racist? And if you are, why are you?
Why am I?
Yeah.
Because that's all I've known my whole life. That's all I've known. And that's how I've been my whole life. I can't just change who I am, you know? I have my feelings, how I personally feel, you know? Even when it comes to racism, that's your own personal beliefs. Everybody has them. You know?
But isn't it part of the American beliefs that we're all supposed to live together? From many comes one. It's easy to talk hard when you're inside the gates, but what happens when you leave?
People ask me, what do I think of the Canyon Lake? Canyon Lake's absolutely normal. It's the people. I haven't seen a newspaper in a week. I don't know what's going on in Iraq. I don't know what's going on in L.A. Some Mexican guys on the corner said the whole Latin people of this country going on strike Monday, and I got no clue, but it's nice in there, bro.
I just have to get out for a day. So I drive down to Campo, last stop USA. Here they have the ultimate gate, the one that fences out Mexico, except the gate doesn't work. No one knows how to solve the problem, and the Border Patrol cars sit idle in the parking lot. 12 million illegals are living inside the country, and more coming every day. The latest big idea? You guessed it, build an even bigger gate. Just another gate, beyond the gates, beyond the gates. These are the Minutemen, concerned citizens or vigilantes, depending on who you ask.
Border Patrol? Yeah.
They've taken it upon themselves to do the job the government seems unable to do, personally guard the frontier.
What's your beef? You know, what's the beef?
We are experiencing a full invasion of our country by foreign nationals. This issue is pitting brother against brother, neighbor against neighbor, and that's the seeds of a civil war.
One out of every two new homes in California is built behind a gate.
If they have enough money to build behind a gate, that's what they do. So we're going to be a two-class system. We're going to be upper middle class and the rich, and then you're going to have the poor. There's not going to be any middle class to pay the taxes anymore.
A Minuteman tells me they've detained some Mexicans further up the road who they think are trying to sneak in. We take a drive.
Who are these guys?
Two guys in stretch pants pedaling around the desert. Peculiar.
You guys Mexican citizens or American?
We're both. I got dual citizenship.
Where you live, man?
In Mexico.
Man, this is our country. That's your country. You stay in your country, we'll stay in ours. So you guys need to fix your country where it pays good wages. Then you wouldn't have to come up here unless you just wanted to visit.
The fences we build around our homes in California are to keep who out?
The bad guys.
Who are they?
The criminales, the criminals.
Are they?
You mean the bad guys are the immigrants?
I don't hate Mexicans. I hate illegal aliens. That's illegal Mexicans, illegal Chinos, illegal Middle Easterners. Anybody coming in the back door without permission are invading my country.
You didn't mention any Europeans in that list.
Well, there's some, but they usually don't come through the southern border.
What's the deal for those fences? I don't understand it because I don't have fences in my house. Anybody's welcome to come and knock on my door and everything. I live in a nice neighborhood.
Most of these men are weekend warriors or suburban cowboys. But there's one lone man at the far end of the hill who's been standing vigil for 500 days.
If every white man decides to wall himself off,
yeah,
what's left out there?
There's been a systematic Sisyphication of the society all my life. You know, the gate is a manifestation of the insecurity that they feel. And the insecurity they feel is because their own government won't allow them to defend themselves from threats that they feel.
The next morning, May the 1st, immigrants go on strike across the country. It's called A Day Without a Mexican. Hundreds of thousands of people making a point. The country's divided, gates or no gates. In Lake Elsinore, the shops are closed and the workers from the street corners are nowhere in sight. Back in Canyon Lake, Randy and Denise are having a party to celebrate a Mexican holiday, Cinco de Mayo. With no one to hire, I come as the mariachi. Somebody has to. What's a Mexican holiday without a Mexican? The men drink. The women shop. The trousers give me a rash. Spend a while in Canyon Lake and you'll realize there are gates within gates within gates. Do the fences we build work, or do they just lead more and more to isolation? From the world, from our community, from ourselves. Once you're locked in, how do you get out?
How are you doing, Monty?
I am fine. How are you?
This is my caddy, young man, in your community. His name's Remy.
How are you? Nice to meet you, Monty.
Everyone knows it's not what you know, it's who you know. So I bring Remy as my caddy. He's done poorly in school and has few skills beyond video game killing.
In your opinion,
yes,
what's the most important thing a young man should possess?
Desire to learn. Have a passion for learning, man, so you're always inquisitive. Have respect for other people and just follow the golden rule, man. Yeah. That way you wind up educated, respectful, and smart. You think?
Well, I guess I'm screwed then, huh, sir?
Is that so? Only you. Yeah. Only you know that.
It's
straight up, see where the palm trees are?
Yeah.
Straight up there, you look, it's almost a straight shot.
Okay. Oh yeah, okay.
Nice throw. Perfect.
Good shot, sir.
Barring a career as a caddy or a professional video game hitman, Remy wants to join the Marines. As it happens, Monty served in the Army.
If you want to go in the military, you've actually known people that have done it, and that's something from your heart, I think you should go, because it can do nothing but good.
I completely
recommend it if you can hack it.
Do you want your son to go?
I would let my son go, if that's what he wants.
You want him to?
If he did, I would say go officer country. You know?
First.
Huh?
Go to school first.
Go to school first. Get that degree first. Absolutely. 250 yards. Yeah, my wife and I have conversations about that.
Yeah?
Yeah, because he wants to be in the military.
A lot of dudes dying out there.
Well, I think with God and all, I don't really have to fear death because what if I die?
Be a warrior.
Huh?
Be a God's warrior, man.
Yeah, if I die, I know where I'm going.
From the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tivoli.
I get a call from a woman named Brianna who's seen my name in the community paper. She claims she's been so shamed and slandered that she's now selling her home.
I moved here to get away, to be in a gated community, to be safe. And it's not that way. In Canyon Lake, there's two things to do. Three things. You can have an orgy. You can gossip. And you can drink. That's it.
You do all this?
I've never had the orgy.
How do you know that?
Not yet. That's what I'm trying to get out of here.
Canyon Lake is a big little place. People had already told me about Brianna. She has a reputation as the town good time girl. The streets of this town are littered with broken hearts. Danny's one of them. He wrote a song about his former love.
Why are you leaving? Be honest.
I don't like it here.
One guy wrote a song about you.
How'd you know that?
It's Canyon Lake.
One guy? Try three. Okay. I have a little bit of a reputation around here that I like them young. So.
Do you?
Mm-hmm. Well, I know when I first moved here, all of a sudden I became the number one MILF, and I didn't know what that meant. So.
What's a MILF?
Mother I'd like to fuck. So, I didn't know what it meant. And then, you know, I've had my fun. But as far as, I think the people, I don't know who you've spoken with, but they may wish.
Is that why you're leaving? That kind of crap? You're the MILF and all that? And...
Yeah, that kind of crap. Just the stuff that people say and the things that get started and then you get pulled into it.
It seems Brianna got pulled into one of those things. It turns out an unstable man was let through the gates of Canyon Lake, kidnapped his ex-girlfriend, and burned her new boyfriend's house down.
The search continues tonight for a man accused of kidnapping his ex-girlfriend. Police say he is armed and dangerous. They believe he kidnapped this woman, Stephanie Creech, his ex-girlfriend.
Riverside County Sheriff's Department is heading up the search. They say Gersey somehow was able to force his way into her house and take her against her will out of her gated community of Canyon Lake.
We lived two houses away from the burned house. It was pretty scary when we heard that it possibly could be someone who came and lit it.
To get in here, you actually need to be called in from the gate. So, you know, somebody had to have called him in. So that's, you know, kind of weird.
We can't deny entry to homeowners, and we're not required to check everybody in the car for who they are. So he could easily just get in with one of his friends.
Brianna did know Eric. She admits as much. Rumors went around that she was the one to let him in the gate, which she denies. But the gossip gets even more vicious than that.
The day that supposedly he started that fire, he was here. And the rumor got started that Eric was at my house that day and held me by gunpoint and fucked the shit out of me. To throw me in a situation like that, where nothing like that ever happened, and to start a rumor like that, that was it. That was the straw that broke the camel's back.
Fires, kidnapping, guns, and Canyon Lake, the safest city in California. I might live in Los Angeles, but no one ever got kidnapped in my neighborhood. So this makes me wonder what else is smoldering behind the gates. I get hold of a police report. Turns out rapes have doubled from 3 to 6. Car thefts and felony arrests were up, and 6 registered sex offenders actually live here. Canyon Lake had nearly twice as many rapes per capita than the City of Angels. Serious crime does exist here. The chief of police always seemed to be busy fighting crime, so this guy has to answer my questions.
It's one of the safest cities in California, so I wanted to talk about the crime stats.
Okay.
You're an expert in crime. It's down about 9% this year, right? But look at this. Felony arrests are up 240%, misdemeanor arrests up 31%, total arrests are up almost 50%, rapes have doubled, but overall crime is down. Is it? I mean, is this really more safe than the average city, or is it like some stuff doesn't go reported because there's POA?
I can't look at these numbers and say one thing or another. I don't know what these arrests were for. Were they drug arrests?
I don't know, but that's what they give the public. So, you know, if they're going to tell me, like, hey, move in, it's, you know, property values are great because we got no crime, but what are we talking about?
So I walk a few doors down to the local newspaper. Is serious crime going underreported? Or worse, being ignored for the sake of image and house prices?
Trying to find out what goes on in Canyon Lake through the police department is very, very difficult. We try. I mean, we know an accident happens and we can't get a report on it. We know that there's a drug bust and we can't get a report on it. I know there are skinheads that live here. At least there have been in the past. I know that a lot of things happen at night that we never hear about.
The property value thing, if like there's no record of it, then it appears safe.
Mm-hmm.
Safer it appears, the more your house is worth.
Well, yeah. It's true.
So maybe the powers that be are doing you a favor.
I'm sure that, maybe that plays into it. I don't know. I don't have time to follow up on crime. Besides that, I would rather follow up on nice people. All the nice people that live here. You know what I mean?
The gates provide security, right?
Yeah.
It's the main thing. I looked up the police stats. Do you know rape has doubled in the last year inside this place?
And what's the numbers?
6 reported rapes.
Uh-huh.
Who's providing you with this information?
The police. I mean, I know it's a safe place, but...
We were voted the safest city in the country a couple of years ago and still are.
Yeah.
But an uptick in crime, don't you have to...
You know what I think? I think since we started letting the media in...
Oh. Go ahead.
Go ahead. Since the media got in, I have noticed a rampant increase in all manner of crime within the lake.
Somebody does have to report it so we know what's going on.
Are the rapes and the felonies from people that are owners? Are they renters?
I don't know. Not enough information. You know, younger women talk about it. Something that, you know, the community's changing.
It's cyclical here. It's changed several times. It'll change again. But most of the changes are for the better.
I go over to Brianna's to help her pack some boxes. But when I get there, she's not packing at all. She's drinking liquor with a man named Large.
Well, it's a big-ass white man hiding behind some gate. Who you fear?
The whole thing, I fear nobody.
Well, damn, what you need a gate for?
Large is indeed a very large man, and he insists on giving an interview. But his chest is too hairy and the microphone tape won't stick. So I use plastic meat wrapping instead.
You're running from something. We're all running from something. Everyone I know in Canyon Lake is running from something.
I'm not away from nothing.
What are you running from?
I'm not running from anything. No, I'm saying wherever she goes, the problems are there.
I know where she is. I know what they say about it.
Why should she be the object of derision, of ridicule, of songs, of parodies? She's wild. She's cool. And the minute you touch the flame, you start to spit on it. Is that about right, Brianna? Yeah. So?
So tell me something I don't know.
I'll tell you what you don't know. I could have been the best friend you ever had.
And you know what? You fucked that up.
You fucked it up.
You fucked that up, girlfriend. Whatever. I still love you.
And the problem is that I don't fucking love you. That's the fucking problem.
Well,
that's why you've said the stuff you've said about me.
What are you talking about? Why don't you explain yourself instead of being a fucking rambunctious bitch?
What the crew and I hadn't realized was that these two had history. In the magnifying glass of Canyon Lake, large is just another ant, albeit a very large ant, crawling around Brianna's honeypot. Another trash-talking broken heart.
You're stepping right on base.
Yeah.
Your turn.
Right. After my $30,000 fucking dollar ring got stolen, you called me and called me a cunt and said I deserved it. So fuck
and
you.
And you know the fuck you did.
And you know what? I'm still nice enough to let you in my house.
So
I'm
talking to you about karma and you won't listen to me.
I don't need your karma and your pseudo-fucking Christian because you go to some fucking biker church. I don't need that. God is in my fucking house. I don't need your shit, and I don't need you to tell me and ask me to come to church with you.
Why are you so pissed off at me? When you left me in jail, why did you leave me in jail?
I'm not gonna bail you out. You got your fucking home after
shit.
Trouble.
You don't do shit. And you know what? Fuck this shit right here. And I had about a fuck enough because I knew it would turn out this way. Excuse me, I'll pay for that, bro.
You're right, dude.
Go fuck them youngsters and all the people who give a fuck about you. And you know what, girlfriend?
As I look at Brianna, I can see her stewing in the social pressure. Outside the gate, she'd have the freedom of anonymity. But in a community that's built on conformity and family values, she's too big a fish for this lake.
I feel like a deer in a tiger's den right now.
Sometimes security comes at a price, the loss of your freedom. Even though she was not allowed to vote, Denise learns today if she's elected to the property owner's board.
Thank you, God, for all the things that you did for us and continue to do for us.
Thank you, God, for all the things that you do for us and continue to do for us.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm getting a little nervous. What if they know tonight and I didn't win?
Then we move on.
Where are we moving to?
Back to normal.
Okay.
Yay. I'd like to introduce the three members who have won. Travis Montgomery, Roger Windler.
Denise is elected and is bestowed the status she craves. But in this land of the good old boys, will she be able to make a difference?
If she's going to vote on something that's contrary to what she feels, she's going to have to be convinced that that is the right thing for the community. What did you see that she needs to do?
You gotta do something about the kids.
You definitely gotta do that. Well, let's do it. Let's jump on it.
Yeah. Your community.
And today, Remy has an appointment with his future, the United States Marine Corps. He'll find out if he's got the stuff to survive in the real world.
My name is Gunnar Sarmaris. Once you have a seat here, you know why you're here?
Because I wanted. Hopefully join the Marines when I get out of high school.
Okay. Well, what I'd like to do there at Remington, if you don't mind, I'd like to ask you a few questions, all right? Are you have a police record or not?
No.
No? Okay. All right, how about drug use? Cocaine, LSD, marijuana. Not even one time?
I've
some?
Smoked pot, and that's it.
So you smoke marijuana? How many times?
I used to smoke pot a lot, but then I quit.
Okay, well, did you have a clipboard and you were marking each time you took one?
No.
So I don't really know how much it is. I need you to be just the best to your ability because everything will come, we'll uncover everything. We do police checks, do background checks, we do, if you were to move forward, I do piss tests. If you're hot, you know what I'm talking about, you're hot. All right, now I just need a number. How many times you smoke marijuana? You're the only one who knows. 5, 10, 20?
200.
200 times.
bad.
I just asked the questions. You gave me the information. So you got about 15, 20 minutes of your time. I'm going to set you up in the computer room. Okay? This is a practice test, okay? Mm-hmm. However, this thing's going to identify where you're at when you take the real test. Good luck.
It's not a good sign. It's slowing. It's real slow.
You scored a 19. You know what? Out of possible, you know what? Out of a possible 99.
Ouch.
Yeah. I can't do nothing with you. You know why? Because you didn't meet the qualifications. You don't have what it takes right now to become a Marine. Okay? That's not the end of the world. I'm just letting you know what's up right there. And my conversation will be done right now because I don't want to waste any more time. I'm sure you have things to do.
Yeah.
True?
I got things to do.
Well, I have things to do.
Waste your time, you know?
Okay.
Ugly chunks on that one.
I feel sorry for the kid. I feel sorry for a lot of the kids here. Their families try to give them everything. But are they prepared for the real world? Do they have any idea what's out there? I think of piglets ready for the slaughter. Blue skies, blonde hair, green water. Canyon Lake's a safe place where people seem to die only of old age. In America, everyone has the right to raise their family as they see fit, to secure their property, and to expect something in return for their tax dollars. But at what cost? How can a country of immigrants stand as one if the rich continue to wall themselves away? The poor will find them. They already have. They're just outside the gates. In life, they say you do things for your children. Would I raise my kid here? Maybe. There's worse places.
You know what they say? It doesn't happen inside those gates. It just doesn't happen.
There's just too many places I've got to see. Cause I'm as free as a bird now. And this bird you
say about the programme at bbc.co.uk/bbc4. And tomorrow, don't miss a special edition of Dinner with Portillo on the legacy of George W. Bush at 10. Stay with us tonight for more murders and more suspects. Spiral is next.